Folks, pretty soon, our crabby friend here is going to be 110% essential for Don't Starve Together's newest endgame. The Eye of the Storm is upon us, and I get the feeling that the Crab King here is still going to be a major obstacle for many out there looking to participate in it. So then, why not just add one more little method of murder to the list, yes? One that has been around since the very start, yet one we've never really done in a guide form. The seaweed method. Let's light him up. Well, actually, we might need to find him first, and herein lies the first bloody hurdle in all this. Sure, while the Crab King is supposed to spawn in our swell oceans, aka the waters directly beyond the coastal ones, the game tends to be really wonky with ocean generation, so for all intents and purposes, the guy can bloody spawn anywhere. And that's a problem. A big one too. But there is a way to locate him without ever stepping foot on a boat, actually. The thing is, however, it's not that easy in and of itself. But even considering when you are likely to be wanting to usurp the Crab King, I have a feeling one will still choose this instead of sailing around for ages. But what is this other option? Well, the Astral Detector, folks, obtained via activating the ancient archives here, finding and flushing a literal toilet filled with blue water, and blue water specifically, mind you, for a distilled ball of knowledge, and then ultimately solving the puzzle of the ancient orchestrina here with said ball on it in order to unlock the very specific blueprint for said astral detector. Now, it is obviously far more involved than what you just heard, but again, if you're going for a Crab King kill, I think you got enough knowledge yourself to handle all this. Oh, and then all of this, of course. But all this is just using the Astral Detector to locate every piece of every celestial altar, and the game makes it bloody easy by literally pointing us in the right direction. That's why I say, you've got this, folks. So find the two pieces of the Celestial Sanctum, be sure to have mined the inviting formations on a lunar island for the Celestial Altar pieces, of course, and then, and only then, will the Astral Detector tell us where dinner is. Got it? Good, cause we've got more to do. Like all of Pearl's nonsense, if you choose to do so, of course. But still, finding and completing Pearl's friendship quest is actually way, way easier at the end of the day, so why wouldn't you? Just find one message in a bottle out there on the water, and the game will actually pinpoint the location of her island for you, and then chances are, you will have done most of her quest well before preparing for the fight itself. But keep hold of her pearl regardless, as we here still have more to do. And unfortunately, it's more bloody sailing potentially. But what can you do, eh? Yup, it's finally seaweed time, everyone. And thankfully, this whole shebang is also one of the easier parts of it all at the end of the day. Seaweeds love generating in deeper oceans. But again, oceans are kind of weird at times, so who knows where you will actually run into them. But whatever the case, they usually spawn in large numbers and many groups regardless. So I do not think you're going to have any issues here. You will, however, have issues if you don't know how to handle these things properly. So listen up. Do not try anything with these things unless it is nighttime, folks. At night, the terrifying plant things all go to sleep, and we can murder them one at a time for their sea sprout starters, no problem whatsoever. But if you attempt this at any other time, you're gonna find any nearby weeds joining in the fight, and you do not want that. Trust me. Murder at night, period. Then, take as many sea sprout starters as you can over to wherever your Crab King spawn is, and proceed to plant as many as you bloody can or want on his nearby sea stacks. And an oar and an anchor is gonna help tremendously with this. But yes, since we need sea stacks to transplant seaweeds, you need to keep as many of them intact as you can, so be mindful there. Now you don't actually need that many seaweeds, mind you, but this is one of those cases where the more the merrier, and faster too. But you know what's not fast? The unfortunate waiting game following our transplanting. For you see, sea sprouts have many, many stages of growth before they become seaweeds. So it's gonna be a bit before we actually take part in the fight here. As roughly 2 days after we plant a starter, the sprouts will bud as you can see. But then 2.5 to 4 days after that, the sea sprouts would begin to grow into their stage one barnacle growth. And this is where the real waiting game begins, as 2.5 to 4 days following stage one will come stage two, of course. And then yes, you guessed it, 2.5 to 4 days following stage two will come stage three, and then, and only then, can the sea sprouts grow into full seaweeds come a full moon night, everyone. Oh yeah, it's a whole bloody thing. But thankfully, it can all happen off-screen and in the background. And that's very good for us, as we've got one last bit of preparation to discuss, everyone. What gems do we use? And how will we get him to use his ice attack to begin the actual method? Well, they kind of go hand in hand, really. So very much contrary to what I've always told you to do for the Crab King fights, I am recommending full-on blue gems for it. Or maybe a mix of blue and purple if the former doesn't really sit right with you. But we need this freeze attack to hit our seaweeds. So we're in essence helping ourselves by helping the king. But now comes the fun part. Starting the fight and getting him to launch this ice attack we keep mentioning at least one time. Now I don't care how you do it, but you have to have the king involved in combat until his health drops below 85%, or as you dip out of there as something else does so for you. Yes, even if he doesn't reach the 85% health threshold, the guy loves to use his freezing move when we ourselves are not involved for some reason. And this is why I kinda use bees to my advantage, even a small number of them. But a word of warning, he loves to use this freeze attack, as I said, and it is a major problem. While he will aggro the seaweeds, of course, he will be able to freeze them over and over and over again as much as he wishes before they have a chance to thaw. So we're going to have to be involved in this fight one way or another, folks. So I hope you're a decent sailor, or you have a buttload of boat patches. Or both, for you see, we will need to sail in circles around the Crab King's domain in order for the game to believe that we are in the fight proper ourselves. Not too close, mind, but close enough, unfortunately. And I say it's unfortunate because it is easier said than done. Especially depending on where he actually spawned, of course, and the nearby sea stacks. Because of that, there may be times where he's able to launch another freeze attack or two if we get too far from him. And that's usually what it means. If he does it, you're too far. If he continues to launch geysers at your boat, however, it means you're actually doing it right. And your seaweeds should be absolutely wrecking them, even if he does get some healing phases in, because my goodness, they shoot fast and they deal a lot of damage. Now, there have been some opportunities here to change things up to your liking already, like how we could have started the fight and sailed away from it on the same exact boat, perhaps. You could have just stood and patched up your boat over and over and over again throughout the entire fight if you had the patches to just avoid sailing, and you could have been involved in the fight yourself up until you saw any of the ice crystals forming and then have teleported away instead of what I did instead. Whatever the case though, the methodology is the exact same. We need to get him to freeze a seaweed or two, and the rest are gonna follow. It's a fun method, and it's rather simple actually. It's just gonna take time to arrange, of course. And then afterwards, we can of course reap the spoils of both the inactive celestial tribute here, after we of course fish it out of the water with a pinching witch obtained from Pearl once more, and let's not count out the unique strident trident blueprint that can lead to uprooting kelp, destroying sea stacks with ease, ocean fishing without a fishing rod, our own geyser attack that deals 85 whopping damage each time, and more. Good stuff. And there you have everyone. The Crab King Seaweed Method. Enough said, I think. So thanks for watching, folks. Well wished to all. Light the sucker up. And I'll see ya in the next one. Bye-bye.